Now, you would be having one group of your friends. Your group of your friends, when you see them, there would be a person to whom whenever you give a task, he would always complete it, or if you give him a challenge rather, he will be willing to accept it and do it. There would be a friend who would always take instructions. So whenever someone instructs him to do something, only then he or she would do that particular stuff. So we have this variety of personalities which are there. Now the question comes here, when we are doing this entrepreneurial journey, does the personality of a person matters when it comes to becoming an entrepreneur? Let's find out that. See, when it comes to entrepreneurship, there was this person, Bill Wagner. Now what did he say? He said there are various kind of personality traits which define an entrepreneur. So an entrepreneur needs to have certain skill sets, and certain kind of personalities only can become a successful or can become an entrepreneur as such. But then he came up with these various personality traits which an entrepreneur has. Now what were those? See, he said this, there is one personality type which is known as trailblazer. Interesting name. Let's see, what does that mean? See, he is a person, or she is a person, who is very competitive, very ambitious and goal oriented. So they define their goal, they are very ambitious, so they will keep on working towards achieving that goal, and when it comes to their performance, they are very or highly competitive. So they don't accept mistakes as such, and they keep on coming up with various kinds of strategies to achieve those goals. They are very restless, energetic, and there is always a sense of urgency. You would have seen similar kind of person in your life also. There would be some person, when suppose let's say if you have a plane to catch, so they, you know, you would have seen some personality either at your home or in your friends who always have this sense of urgency to do things like, let's finish it off, we need to catch a plane, we need to do this thing, let's do it faster. So it's always, they keep on pressurizing you. So there's always that sense of urgency in this entrepreneurs. They would always say, let's complete it, let's complete the goals. Why this hasn't been done? What is the reason? So they keep on targeting. They are very restless and their energy levels are very high. Now, remember, trailblazer personalities are very logical, analytical and practical. Okay, they are realistic. So when it comes to problems or when it comes to situation, they have that analytical ability. They analyze the situation and then they come up with solutions. They are practical. That means emotions don't drive them. They come with practical solutions as such. And they are realistic when it comes to setting up goals or setting up targets. Now, the business trends here could, for a trailblazer, would be including medical technology. So they could go into fields like medical technology, finance, legal and consulting fields. These kind of businesses would suit such kind of personality trait. Okay, they can become strong strategic thinkers. They can focus easily on the marketing and the operations part of the business as such. They always prefer, when it comes to business, that they are the driving force, and hence they would always be the driving force of the business. They don't buy franchise or distributorship. So they will never be a distributor or franchisor. They will always prefer that they are owners of the business, and they are in the business where they can be the sole decision maker, or they can be the driving force. They are highly innovative. They always keep on coming up with new products, new ideas, or new way of serving the customers. Now see, when we are discussing these traits, always remember, you can analyze and see which of the traits belong to you, and then probably you can understand if you are an entrepreneur or not. Now the next personality trait here is go-getters. Now who are these? Let's understand them. See, these are the people or entrepreneurs who are higher than, they have higher than level of dominance. What do I mean by this? That means they will have a very high level of dominance. You would be having friends like that, wherein one of the person would be very dominant, and he would be the person who would always have the last word as such in your group. So even in entrepreneurship, we have these go-getters who have very high level of both dominance and sociability. The second attribute they have apart from being dominant is they are very sociable. That means they have a very wide connections. See, in entrepreneurship or being a business person, you need to have a social network. The reason is because the more the contacts you have, the easier it becomes to conduct your business. People are aware about what is your business. It's only through social network or social networking which happens. And when I'm saying social networking, it doesn't mean having many friends on Facebook. It means like having social business contacts as such. So when I'm connected to various people because of, let's say, LinkedIn or because of the meetings I had, so that business network helps me to become sociable in business and do my business in a more effective manner. So these are the two attributes these go-getters have. And remember, they are very driven, independent driven as such. So they are very, they have that driving force in them, and then they are also independent in nature. So they can take, they do not really have to depend on others. If someone says, no, I'll not do your work, they have that capability of doing that work on their own rather than depending on someone. Competitive. See, they are very competitive in nature, but then compared to the earlier personality trait which we discussed, that is trailblazers, the problem here is they are concerned with people. So they are concerned about others, and sometimes because of this, the competitiveness go to a second rank. So sometimes the concern takes up the priority, and then the competitive nature goes down. Now, the third is they're typically good leaders, good managers, and they are very excellent when it comes to motivating others. Okay, so people who are around them will always feel motivated. They'll always feel happy whenever that person is around them. Now, they need not be an expert. Now see, they have this condition of being independent. Okay, then because of this, these kind of people have that capability that even if they do not have the knowledge, if someone is showing tantrums or if they are not able to get someone to do work, they will be a person who will learn everything. So they need not be an expert in any field to start a business. They can just start a business because of this quality. Remember, they perform very well in an unknown and a ambitious environment, and hence any business where the environment is quite ambitious, or any market or any, let's say, product or category where no one has ventured into, these are the people who will easily settle there. They can go and venture into such territories and become successful. Now, the next comes is your managers. So who are the managers? Let's see. See, the managers are dominant and independent in nature, just like our go-getters, but they are goal-oriented. They are quite analytical. That is, they analyze the situation and develop the methods or tools to solve the problems as such. They focus on processes and outcomes rather than on people. Remember, these people, unlike the go-getters, would be more focused on getting the results, getting the targets achieved. They are not really concerned about people. So they would say, I really don't care about you. I want my target to be achieved no matter what. Now, what they think is people are nothing but a vehicle for accomplishing goal. So as such, they really don't have those emotions for the people around them. They think these are the person, or these would be the vehicles through which I can achieve my goals. Remember, managers have a very high level of relaxation. So they are not like the trailblazers who will always have that sense of urgency. These people are very relaxed. So they will always say, the work will get done no matter what. So they'll not have that sense of urgency in them. They deal well with customers. So when it comes to interacting with customers, understanding the customer, they are a good people as such. And remember, when it comes to employees, although they feel that employees are a vehicle for accomplishing goals, but then they treat their employees well. They treat them as extended family. They believe apart from their personal life, this is also an extended family they have. Now, their business strengths as such are doing things on their own, okay, working well behind the scene, okay, love working with the system. So one thing is they can independently work. Second thing is when it comes to working behind the scenes, they are good in that. They love working with systems, so any kind of technology related work is very good for them. They come up well with concepts, ideas and technologies. Remember, because I told you they are good at facing the customer, interacting with the customer, they excel at competitive selling. Now, they need to hire employees who are better than them when it comes to listening and working well with others. Because of their thinking when it comes to this trait, that they think that people are a vehicle for accomplishing goals. Hence, when they are employing someone, they need to ensure that they employ a person who can overcome this trait and who is a person who can work well with others. Now, these people are more successful in businesses which are related to technology or where the customer is playing a dominant role. Let's see the next personality type. Now, this is a motivator. Okay, so an entrepreneur who is also a motivator. Who is this person? See, again, they have a high level of sociability. So, they will have a lot of business contacts as such. They will have an above average level of dominance in the work. And they are both driven, that is, they are a driving force as such in the business, and they are independent also. What they do is a consummate motivator. So they are a kind of motivator who will work well by and ensure that they are not only working well, they will ensure that the other people which are with them, they are also providing those results. Okay. The business trends for them is retail, or where people are a big equation. So they succeed in those kind of businesses where you have to face the customer. The customer equation is very high, like retail shops, okay, or retail places. Now, convincing and avoiding confrontations by these are their two traits. So they are very good in convincing someone, and they are very also good in avoiding confrontations. How do they avoid such kind of arguments? By creating a counter argument, which is strong emotional argument. So if someone is trying to confront them, they will oppose it by creating a strong emotional argument. Now, they do well again in customer facing roles like managers, as they can again see both sides of argument. So whenever they are into argument, no doubt they have this convincing attitude, and they have this attitude of responding the confrontation by a strong emotional argument, but then they also have the ability to see both sides of arguments. Remember, they are very good motivators, so they excel in sales job or something which is related to sales and leadership. Being motivators, they are good at nurturing relations, and they often do best in business where you have to keep clients for a long term. So any businesses where the client should keep on coming back to you, let's say a professional service wherein the client should keep on coming back whenever there is a requirement, such kind of businesses are suitable for them. They thrive well in team environment, so they are very good when it comes to working in a team environment. Now, the next type is your authoritarians. Who are these people? See, these are considered to be the backbone of the society as such. Now, they will not be very good when it comes to founding or laying the foundation of an entrepreneurship or laying down the foundation of an enterprise. Rather, they are very good or excellent when it comes to being a distributor or a franchisee or a owner of an existing business. So when I tell them to become a franchisee as such, let's say if they buy the franchisee or the franchise of McDonald's, they would be very good in that, running that business, because they are the people who follow a set of rules or regulations. They are very good in following the rules and the policies. They are detailed and tactical oriented, and they are always motivated in doing the things in a right way. That is, they love to follow the policies and the rules which are laid down, and they always want to be on the right side of the law. They are very diligent and cooperative, and again, they are very good, as I just told you, in following the procedures which is being told to them. In terms of nature, they are very relaxed, they are very patient, and they are accommodative and good as a team player. They always tend to avoid any kind of confrontation. Now, in terms of businesses, any kind of franchisee business or dry cleaning stores, liquor stores or convenience stores where the need of the product or service is strong, would be good for such kind of people. Remember, these are accidental entrepreneurs. So they would have become entrepreneurs not because they wanted to become, but because the circumstances forced them to become an entrepreneur as such. Now, most authoritarian entrepreneurs would need a partner who is having a strong natural ability to prospect or to network. Okay, so they require a person who can network on their behalf or who can suggest ways to do the business in a better manner because they are unable to do so. Now, let's move further. Collaborators. Who are these people? See, these are again a social people. So they have that sociability skill in them. They have the ability to influence others and get what they want from that other person. You would be seeing that there are people who have the ability to convince you and then influence you in such a manner that you will be doing what he wants. Okay, so let's say if he wants you to buy a product, so he will have that influencing skill by telling you that yes, this product is the most useful product and the price you're paying for the product is the best. So they have those skills in them as such. Remember, but they are not very comfortable with cold calling. So if you tell them to pick up the phone and dial the numbers from the directory, they would not be very good in that. They are not comfortable pitching new ideas. They therefore need an aggressive partner along with them to do it. Okay. When it comes to businesses, they are good at customer service oriented. So running a customer service oriented or retail business would be ideal for them, or they would be settled, or they would be available, or they would be good in a business where they have to convince the customer. So where convincing is an important aspect of getting the job done, then they are the people who should be doing it. Okay, they are very good salesperson, so it is better for them to be in such kind of businesses where the role of salesperson is very important. Now, collaborators are good at warm selling. What is warm selling? If suppose a person, that is a prospect, is brought to them, they will have the ability to turn that prospect into a buyer. Now see, if you go to a car dealership shop, everybody who is going there is a prospect out there, because you would only go to a car dealer when you want to buy a car. Okay, so these people, when such kind of people come to them, they are good in turning that prospect into client. Okay, they can also use that prospect to get more information about their product or service. So they are the people from whom you can expect that any prospect who walks back to them, they will get the information and they will ensure that all the information which is required to be passed on to the prospect about their product or service, that was done. Okay, so generally remember here, when it comes to warm selling, the meaning here is the prospect comes to them. So sometimes warm selling happens is through a letter or advertisement, wherein based on that letter or advertisement, the prospect contacts this kind of a collaborator, and then information about the product and services is taken from the collaborator. Now, let's do the next one, that is diplomats. Okay, now these are restless people. Okay, and they will actually perform very well when a lot of pressure is put on them. So these are the restless people who work well under pressure. They can do things very quickly and they work well when they are given deadlines as such. They have high sense of urgencies. So just like trailblazers, they are always in a rush. They will always have that urgency in their nature. They like variety. So they get bored with monotonous tasks if they have to do the same thing again and again. They have the ability to do multiple tasks at one go. So they are the people who love to do multiple things in at one time. Now, they are best when it comes to being a specialist entrepreneurs, as they are sociable and they have that drive when it comes to their personality. They have that influencing, they have that charisma in their personality to influence people, to drive them towards them. So they are very good in becoming a specialist entrepreneurs. For them to be successful, they typically need to hire strong and more result-oriented personalities. So they need to look out for people or personalities who are result oriented, and they should be hiring people who can make sure that the deadlines are met, commitments are kept by them, and the staff members follow through on duties.